स्टूडेंट्स, एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस सर।
यस, ओके। सो आई विल शो यू वन एग्जांपल। स्टूडेंट्स काइंडली टेल द आंसर्स फॉर दिस स्ट्रिंग स्लाइसिंग, ओके, एंड स्ट्रिंग एक्सेसिंग। एक्चुअली डिस्प्लेइंग ए सिंगल कैरेक्टर आल्सो कमिंग अंडर स्ट्रिंग स्लाइसिंग, ओके। सो सी, kindly everyone listen, students, and try to tell the answer.
Sir, your mic is muted, sir.
Students, am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So kindly tell me the output for this one, the first one, students.
Sir, I.
Okay, so start from zero here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so it shows this I. Okay, so now what will be output for this one? Yes, 6 or 5.
Sir, it's error, sir.
Yes, it will show. Oh, an error. What error?
So name error.
Yes, name error. Actually, this variable is not defined, so it shows an name error. Okay, so kindly understand, whatever the variable they are using, you have to access that particular variable name. Okay, so tell me this one, students. What is the output for this one? S7 4.14.2. Actually, in this slice operator, what is the starting value?
So 4. It will start from C.
C. Okay, capital C. Then 14 means which character?
So it goes till 0. Sorry, O.
This is not 0, O. Okay, so it stops at here. Okay, M is the 14th character, so it stops one before this. But students, this O will not display. Understood? Because 4 means this is it will create a range of elements like 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. This kind of locations it will take. Okay, so whatever the character present in the 4th location, it will display. Then 6th location, 8th location, 10th location, 12th location, like this. Okay, so it skips one value. This is the understanding. Kindly understand, students, you have to know how to give the positive indexing and the negative indexing. Understood? So I will show you the output now. Kindly listen. Actually, it will show error for S6. Students, everyone note down this example. S5, S7 are created, and S5 of 8 means it displays I. Actually, this displays this I. Then S6, it's showing name error. See here, name S6 is not defined. Okay, so without clearing doubt, we cannot go for the next step. Okay, so line by line execution. So without clearing this doubt, we cannot go for the next step. So it is disabled. Okay, so we have to clear this, then only we can execute the next one. Okay, so I, the next one you say C D R space O. okay, C means this one, then 6th position D, then 8th position R, 10th position space, 12th position O. Okay, this is the output. for this string slicing. Students, everyone understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Any doubts, Pa? Anybody having doubts? Okay, so next we will go for the next topic. So in see in the right side, students, this side, right side, these are the topics we should cover. Okay, so we created the strings, multi-line strings, and by using string constructor. Okay, then yesterday we saw access by the index slicing a string. Okay, string slicing, that is a getting a part of string from the original string by using slice operator by mentioning start value, stop value, and step value. Okay, the next one is modify a string. Modification of a string. Actually, the string is a immutable data type. We cannot change the data present in the string. Okay, that will produce an error. Okay, see, it is tempting to use the square operator on the left side of an assignment in order to convert a character into string. Okay, if you try to do this kind of change, means it will produce an error. Okay, it triggers an error like type error, string object does not support item assignment. Okay, if you created the string, means that is the final one, you cannot change the particular string. Students understood? But why they given a topic modify a string? Students, everyone understood? String is a immutable, we cannot change. Understood or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes. If you want to change that particular string, means you can use a new variable. Okay, if this is a yes, means you can create another variable, t or like this variable, new yes, or any variable you can use, and in that you can change the variable. Okay, how to change, means I want to change this h to j. Okay, I want to change this. So they are using this another method, j plus s of 1 colon. Okay, so this is a string slicing. They are getting part of 1 to end value. Okay, they are getting these values except h, and but before that they are joining j. Okay, so this plus operator actually will work as a concatenation. Okay, so we already know the addition in the numbers. Okay, addition, 5 plus 3 it will give you 8. Okay, 10 plus 15 it gives you 25. So that is a addition in the numbers. Okay, but if you use this plus operator in the strings, means the same addition is called as concatenation. Okay, understood? So if you do this, it will give output like, see, Jello World. Okay, instead of h, now it replaced as j, and we are actually concatenating the remaining things. Because we cannot change the original data, but this is an alternate way to change the data and show in the screen. Understood, students?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So this concatenation is very, very important. I will show you what are the operators we can use it in the string. Okay. So see here. If you want to add these two strings means we can use concatenation. Okay, new variable I can create. See, SSS equal to S5 plus S7. Okay, so actually this will add these two datas. Okay, that is called a concatenation. So don't say as addition, students, this is a concatenation. Understood, everyone? We are creating new string by adding these two strings. Concatenation of two strings. Understood, everyone? See, S5 created, S7 also created, and I'm going to create triple S, information technology, the coder's room. Okay, the same string contains both the strings are concatenated here. Understood, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, so kindly write this topic, concatenation. We can do this concatenation in the string. Okay, if you use plus operator, it is called as concatenation. okay? And we already know this operator. See, I'm going to show you one more operator that we already know. That is a augmented assignment operator or a shorthand assignment operator. Okay, see, S S S equal to S 5. Sorry. Okay, so see, S7 equal to, sorry, S7 plus equal to, hello. Okay, so S7, this is equal to S7 equal to S7 plus hello. Okay, so you cannot say this, this is equal to changing the value. Okay, this is not the changing the character. We are actually assigning a new string into the same S7. Okay, that is this previous data going to delete, and we are changing the entire string. Okay, entire string change is possible, but changing a single characters or group of characters is not possible in the string. Okay, students understood? So now tell me, students, what will be the output for S7 now? S7 equal to S7 plus hello. This is the shorthand operator we are using. Students, what is the output now? S7 we already have hello. Yes, the coder's room already having here plus hello means this will be concatenated with the hello. Okay, so you will get the output, the coder's room hello. Okay, these are, see, it immediately updated. Okay, previous step you see it showing only the coder room. We are changing the string, but actually not changing the characters. We are assigning a new string to the same variable. Okay, this is like deleting the old one and creating new with the same name. Okay, it looks like modification, but it actually not a modification. We are creating again the same variable. Okay, and we are getting the output, the coder's room hello. Students understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So this is a one arithmetic operator we can use, and another one that is called a repetition. Okay, S7 into 2 star operator we can do with in numbers for multiplication. Okay, 5 into 2 means we will get a 10. Okay, 15 into 4 means we will get a 60. Okay, that is for multiplication, but here it is called as a repetition. Okay, kindly note down, repetition means that particular string will be repeated for the specified number of times. Okay, so here I specified 2, so it's going to repeat 2 times the same string. The entire string will be repeated for 2 times. Understood? If you give 3 means the particular string will be repeated for 3 times. Students understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I will show you the output. So first one, S7 repeated for 2 times, and the second one, S5 will be repeated for 4 times. Okay, so I will show you now. First S5, S7, actually it not changing the strings, but it showing the output by a repetition. Okay, see here, S7 into 2 means the coder's room is repeated for 2 times. The coder's room. Okay, 2 times it is repeating. Then S5 into 4 means, say, information technology 1, 2, 3, then 4. Okay, 4 times it is displaying. Understood? So this is called a repetition. Students, are you understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, kindly note down. Everyone, kindly note down. These are very, very important. Definitely, this will help you to understand a lot of concepts, and we will use many times these kind of concepts. And in MCQ also, they will ask students what will be the output for these functions, this print statement, everything they will ask. Okay, kindly understand. The only two operators we can work with the string is addition operator and multiplication operator, but the name is different here. Okay, the addition operator here we call it as concatenation, multiplication is called as a repetition. Okay, students, everyone noted? Students, everyone noted?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, kindly noted means raise your hands. Okay, okay, good. So we will go for the next one. Students, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Is the screen visible, students?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. So the next one is finding string length. Okay. Finding string length means we can count the number of characters present in the length. Okay. Length means number of characters. Okay. To find the number of characters in a string, we have to use the inbuilt function, len function. Okay, len is the inbuilt function. So actually, if I'm asking what is the length of this string means, you have to count manually. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4 like this up to the last character. But there is a function called the len function. It will count the number of characters and displays in the output. Okay. Students understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So you see len of, that is a function. So you have to use this parenthesis S5. So it will count the length of the S5. So anyone count manually and tell me what is the length? Length means number of characters. Students, what is the output for this one? Len of S5. What is number of characters present in the len S5 is? Including space, you have to count. Students, tell me. What is the length?
22
here. Okay. So next, what is the output for this one? Len of S7 into 2. Len of S7 means this is the length. Okay. So you have to count this. And *2. Okay, the length will be multiplied by 2 and will show the result. Not S7 is repeated for 2 times. Okay, don't think that. It will repeat, it will count the length and the length will be multiplied for 2 times. Okay, so see, I will show you the output. S5, so 22, very good. Then S7, that is a 15 is the length. So that will be multiplied for 2 times. That is the answer for here. Students understood? Because the length is the length means that will return as an integer format. Integer will be multiplied with another integer means that is the multiplication. String into integer means that is called a repetition. Okay? Understood, students? Integer data type plus
yes.
Integer means that is called a addition. Okay, string plus integer. So all the arithmetic operation, we have to include string first. String plus integer means that is called a string plus string. okay, string plus string means that is called a concatenation. Okay, then integer or not only integer, you can use any number format. Here if you use the star means it is called as multiplication, normal multiplication. But string into integer, okay, so don't change the format here. String into integer is the right format. Don't use integer into string, okay. So string is the first one, then star, then only you can specify the number. Okay, so this is called a repetition. Students understood? S5 into 2, this is right one. Okay, so don't use 2 into S5, that is wrong. Don't use this one. If you saw anything in this this kind of thing, definitely this is a error. Okay, so 2 will come right side. Okay, kindly note down these things. This will help you to find the error based questions. Students, everyone noted? Students, everyone noted?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Okay, so now by using this length function, I need you to slice the string up to the last character. How to specify that length in the stop value? Students, before we used one thing, that is I asked the last character, you told that -1. Okay, -1, it will get you the last character. But if you mention means, definitely it will return the one character before. Okay, but now I need this len function and tell me the slicing operator to get up to the last character. Students, now tell me what is the output for this one, then you can easily understand. Students, now tell me what is the output for this one. Print S5 of len of S5. So len of S5 means what is the answer, students? We saw that 22, right? Students?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Len of S5 is 22. So S5 of 22 means what will be the output? Students, anyone?
So it will display
everything. S5 of 22. Students?
So information technology.
Information technology. No, pa. See, this is like accessing the character. S5 of 5 means you know, right? Like this, I am asking S5 of 22. What is the character,
sir,
present in the 23rd position? Why? How?
Sir, but not 22 it will become, sir.
Sir, it will repeat.
No, it will not repeat. See, it's starting from 0 means we have only 22 characters, so the final one will be 21. Understood? So there is no position called 22 here, so it will return the output error. Okay, that is called the index error. Okay, so kindly use according to that. So see, it's showing the error, index error, string index out of range. Out of range means, so we are accessing that is out of this range. We are having only 21 length, but we are accessing more than 21. Okay, so to access the last character, you can use len of S5 -1. Okay, len of S5 we know. If you need last character means len of S5 -1. Okay, so that time it will definitely will show you the output, the last character. Okay, see here Y. Okay. So I am trying to tell you, so this is a formula for finding the last character's index. Okay, len of 5 means it will count the number of characters. If you need to know the last character's index without counting means use this method. len of variable minus 1. Okay, for all the programs, this is a method to access the last character. Understood? Students?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So now tell me what is the output for this one. S5, 0, colon, len of S5, colon, 2. Students, what is the output for this one? So actually this slice operator is equivalent to S5 0 colon 22 colon 2. Okay. Understood? This is equal to this one. So now tell me, students, what will be the output?
Sir, 1 F.
Where is 1?
Sorry. Sir, I.
Yes,
I F.
FR. So the alternative characters will come. Understood?
Yes, sir.
So see here, it will return the alternative characters. Okay, I executed up to the last one. See, I, F, R, A, like that, up to the last one. Okay, it comes up to last one. 22 means actually we can use here the string operator, string slicing, you can use any kind of index. Okay, no issues. But when you are accessing the character, particular character, don't use the index out of range. That will produce an error. Okay?
Okay.
Okay, kindly note down. Students, everyone noted? The len function. So kindly remember all the things. After this class, try to practice. Okay, if you don't practice, means students, that is very difficult to attend any exams, any MCQ, anything. Okay, so kindly do some practice, then only you will be able to understand. Okay?
Yes.
So next one, replace text within a string. Okay, these are string related functions. Okay, string related functions means, so for example, if you are having a string with two, three lines or whatever, maybe, okay, single line or two lines or any paragraph, if you want to replace something, okay, for example, here, instead of world, they are trying to change it as a universe. Okay, so this is a method, we can change it into another string. Okay, we are replacing the string. Okay, so I will show you. Actually, they are replacing and storing in the another variable. Understood, students? See, I'm going to...
Yes, sir.
Yes, so I'm going to use a string. Okay, in this same string I'm going to use repeatedly. Okay. How many times the hello world is appear here, students? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times. Okay, 5 times appearing. But now I want to change this hello as another word. Okay, how to change means you have to use another variable. We are going to change everything and store in another variable. Okay, S2 equal to S1 dot replace. Okay. Inside the function, first you have to use the world word. Okay, hello, the world word we have to mention, and the new word you have to use. Okay, instead of hello, I'm going to use hi. Okay, understood, pa? So now these words will be replaced. This hello will be replaced by hi. Okay, all the hellos are replaced by hi. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So after change, you can access the S2 means it will display the newly updated string. Okay. So I'm executing. You see here the S1 created and the S2. See the replaced word. hello, everything is replaced with a hi and it's showing like this. Okay, so actually when we will use the replace means if you want to update anything commonly in the document means we can use this replace function. Okay, so definitely these things will help you in the 12th standard. That is all the string related functions will be helpful in all the concepts. Okay, so kindly understand replace function is used to replace the old word to a new word. Okay, understood everyone? Students, everyone understood the replace function? Yes, kindly note down. Okay, so now I am going to give one example, another one. So once again, wait. So just listen. Okay, so this is a sentence. Okay, but this is a statement I given to all the boys. Okay, but the same sentence I want to change into to send them to girls. Okay, so what I have to change here, students? The same sentence I have to use it for girls means what I have to change here?
So instead of hello, you should give he, sir.
Only you tell about this one, students. In the sentence only
yes,
you tell,
sir.
Then we'll go
yes,
for
she.
Replace. Yes, we have to use she instead of he. Okay. So what is the change we have to do here? What is the old word we have to change?
Sir, hello and hi you should change, sir.
Now, so in this statement you tell me what we have to use here in this old statement, old word.
Sir, he and she.
He is the old word. What is the new word we have to change?
She.
She. Okay. Yes. Good. So like this, we can change any number of content, not only a single line or single word. You can change a entire book also you can change. Okay. If you did any mistake or anything, or you want to update anything, you can easily change. Okay. See, this is the original string. And S2 is the new string. See, instead of he, everywhere it is replaced as a she. Okay. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, very good. So kindly understand the question carefully, then try to give the solution. Okay. So kindly note down this along with the output, students, everyone. Replace function. So last year everyone studied 10th standard. Now everyone studied 11th standard. Okay, 11th standard you are studying. If I want to change all the content of you, okay, anyway, your name, roll number, that is not going to change. But everyone's standard will be changing. Okay, that grade. Okay, how to change the grade means instead of that 10th, if there is any content, if there is a 10th means we have to change 10th to 11th. Okay, immediately all the content will be changed in that particular string or document. Okay, understood? No need to create a new leaf. We can simply use the old one and we can edit and save it in a new variable. Okay, this is very much useful. Kindly everyone do some practice and understand all the things. Okay, students, any doubts?